What's good, everyone? Welcome to another edition of Yo, It's the Kicks. Got another classic episode today. What a legendary artist, a dope artist from California, representing from Gold Chain Music, my man TriState. So excited to have him on the show today. Let me bring him on live right now. He just popped in, so. What's good, everyone? I see a lot of people joining right now for today's episode. So thanks, everyone, for joining. My name is AB. Welcome to another edition of Yo, It's the Kicks. Got my man TriState, and he'll be on shortly, representing Gold Chain Music. So it's going to be another dope episode. Thanks to everyone that tuned into our last episode this past Monday with Skyzoo, where we talked about his album, The Mind of a Saint, and also Sneakers, right? Yo, It's the Kick. So it's only right. So it was another legendary episode. So cranking out two episodes this week. So excited about that. Excited, you know, for our next guest coming up on the show. But for anybody that's new to Yo, It's the Kicks and GrailzInc, make sure to follow us at GrailzInc to check out our past episodes as well, because we got over about 200 episodes with a lot of legendary artists. So definitely check those episodes out. So we got episodes with Willie Esco, the legendary fashion designer. We got episodes with Vic Spencer, episodes with Durson Howe III, Torrey. So many dope artists, you know, so many dope artists that we follow and we enjoy and love. So check them out. And also, you know, fashion designers too, and people who just fans of the sneaker culture. But definitely check those episodes out. So let me go ahead and bring my man TriState on right now. What's good, TriState?
Yo, peace.
What's up? What's good, man? How's everything going your way, bro?
Everything good, brother. How you?
I'm doing good. Good, man. Thanks for coming on the show, man. Truly appreciate it, man. Been a fan of your music for quite some time now, dog. So, in love what you're doing, man. I love how you combine that flyness, man, with the music, man, over those dope soulful tunes, man. So, love what you're doing, man. I know you got a lot to be happy for, you know what I'm saying? The Air Max King, the project drop, you know, and I feel like you are the Air Max King, for real, man. So, excited to have you on the show, man, to talk about that, man. But, that's good. Everything going good your way, man. Good to see that, man. You know, you healthy. You know, looking good, man. Indeed, you know what I'm indeed. Saying? So that's what's up, man. So that's a blessing, dog. So, man, definitely want to jump in the project. Air Max King, man. I want to talk about that, man. You dropped that, man, you know, basically around Air Max Day, if I'm not mistaken, man. And dope project. I love it, man. Love the production, man. So soulful, dog. I love the mixture, man. You spitting crazy on it, man. You know what I'm saying? Like you always do, man. Just talk about
the project, man. Thank you, brother.
Yeah.
Thank you. First and foremost, I definitely want to shout you out, though, before we jump into that, yo. I love what you're doing with the culture. You know, fashion is a big part of what we do.
Yeah.
Hip hop. You know what I mean? Because nobody wants to listen to somebody who don't look to par, right?
Facts.
So it's always been about fashion. So I appreciate you for, you know, pushing the envelope and, you know, putting the fashion and the culture out on the forefront, brother. So,
yeah, man, appreciate
salute
that.
Salute you.
Thank you, man. Sir. Appreciate those flowers, man. I appreciate that, man. And that's what it's about, man, pushing the culture and also staying authentic with it. You know what I'm saying? So not clout chasing and nothing like that, man. You feel me? Showing love to the people who helped pay the way and continue to pay the way as well, man. Appreciate that love.
Thank you.
Appreciate that,
thank
dog.
Thank you, brother. Yes, indeed. But yeah, as far as the Air Max King, I mean, it is what it is. Every March we celebrate Air Max Day, right? March 26th. So I've been an avid Air Max collector for a minute. So it only felt right for me to be the first and only cat to bring it to the audio side of things, right?
Yeah.
Like we said, fashion goes along with the culture. So, yo, I just felt it. You know, before we got into March, I was looking at my collection going, yo, I got to show the people. You know what I mean? I got to show
real.
What we got. So I just threw the music together real quick. And, you know, that's just the beginning. Every year you can look forward to another edition of the Air Max King. So.
Man, I love that, man, because I love what you're doing, right? I love how you had the skits as well, too, talking about the Air Maxes, right, on the project. So it kind of tied all that in, man. So I love hearing that. And also the music, right? One thing about, like you mentioned, man, as far as fashion, you know, goes right hand in hand. It's part of the culture. But the background, like the backdrops, the beats goes right with it. Like when you listen to it, man, it just on that smooth, soulful, just want to get fly. You know what I'm saying? Top down in the summertime. So I feel like the production, you know, played away with that too. Was that your thinking going to that TriState in the project? Like having those beats to the soundtrack for, you know, being fly and the Air Max King project?
But of course, I mean, at the end of the day, the music has to match the look. Whatever you presenting, you know what I mean? A lot of artists are not really matching the visual with what they present.
Exactly.
You know, vocally and sound wise. So the sound drop, I wanted to make sure the production had a vibe to it, right?
Yeah.
Something that felt like, yo, I'm throwing on a fresh pair of Max today. You know what I'm saying? So it gave you that weather vibe that what you would vibe to it on the day you walk outside and you rocking an Air Max. You know what I'm saying? So you know, which is everyday thing for me. You know, it's just a cultural thing that we all do. Yeah. My whole crew is like this.
The whole crew.
Shout out to Gold Chain.
It really is. Yeah,
shout out to the Gold Chain.
Military
Gold Chain Music. We all represent the same way, man. You know what I mean? So.
And I think just going with the Air Maxes, right? I want to ask you this question. You know, TriState, what's your top five Air Max? Like, if you had to put it in no particular order, right? I'm talking about, like, ranking from like Air Max 1, Air Max 90s, Air Max 95s, Air Max 97. What would be your top five of the signature line in Air Max?
Man, that's crazy. I probably gotta go with the ones, bro. Ones and 90s is like a tie for me.
Got you.
So my collection consists of like a majority of the ones. These are the big bubbles, of course. I know you know about the big bubbles.
Right? Man, so the big bubbles.
Yeah, like you know, we always gotta make sure we got different colors and different renditions of the big bubbles, right? So, but that's where it all started.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? These was the Air Max Ones, 1986.
Facts.
You know what I mean? Shout out to Nike, Tinker Hatfield.
Tinker,
brilliant idea, man, to put the air bubble inside of that. That sole like that, and you know, just the upper. The whole shoe, the silhouette of the shoe is a beautiful shoe, man.
Yeah, it really is.
And you know what's crazy? Air Max 1's are the most comfortable Nike, bro.
So like, it is a very comfortable Nike. That's a fact. It is.
You know, and the mug guard is always sexy. It's just a crazy look, yo. So I think the one is definitely in my top. You know what I mean? In my top. But the 90s is right there. You know what I'm saying?
Man, I love the 90s, too.
I love exclusive. The 90s, I picked up this pair right here. These are called the Vinyls. Ooh, now, these are exclusive.
Crazy.
These, you can only get them in Europe. And they, like, in the UK, they, like, paid homage to all the DJs. So the detail.
Man, I love that.
The detail in these, they got a vinyl, actually, a Nike vinyl on the tongue. So that's kind of ill. And then this right here on the mug guard is all vinyl, like a record.
Damn. Damn, like a record. Yeah, it really like do. The color and everything.
Yeah, the color,
black,
everything, the soul, you know what I mean? The tip of the strings, you got the red, like the, you know, when you turn the light on the turntables, all the DJs, they know what I'm talking about, right? So these are some of my favorite. I still never even rocked these before. So they still crispy. You know what I mean? I just been sitting on those.
Them bottoms crazy. Bottoms.
These are nuts, yo. The 90s, I mean, it's hard to fight a pair of 90s.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Yeah, man. I mean, the Air Max ones is my favorite too. I feel like Tinker half, even though he got a lot of great classes, right? Especially under the Jordan line. But I feel like the Air Max ones, in my opinion, TriState, I feel like they was game changers, right? They was
Man,
game changers in the industry and still relevant
without a
to this
doubt,
day.
without a
And
doubt,
I
brother.
mean, I know my brother was just telling me, he was just in Memphis, my big brother, and he was like, yo, everyone in Memphis got Vapor Maxes on. Like, that's what he was seeing, like, nonstop. So seeing the evolution continue to go and go, man, is really dope just in that signature line of Air Maxes.
And that's what I love about Air Max too, because you could pretty much throw a silhouette, a upper silhouette on top of a sole that has an air bubble, all kind of different ways, yo. You asked me in what order, it'd have had to be ones, 90s, probably 97s.
Ninety
You know what I
sevens
mean?
is
97s, then 95s.
95.
Yeah, so it's tough, you know, but at the end of the day, I feel like you could. It's so many different ways, and you mentioned the Vapor Max. One of my brothers hit me from LA, one of my boys I grew up with, and he was like, yo, I see you about to do the yo, it's the kicks thing. And he's like, yo, you know I collect Air Max. And he hit me FaceTime. He started showing me all his Vapor Max. So he's a avid Vapor Max collector. So it's so many different directions you can go with the
So
Max,
many.
man, you
And
know.
try to stay like growing up, what made you gravitate towards Maxis? Like, what was the joints that made you? I know you mentioned the Air Max ones is probably your favorite ones, but what was the specific colorway and what made you just gravitate to those joints and become a avid fan of the Air Maxis?
Actually, it was this cat I went
Okay.
to high school with. Shout out to Fairfax High School, Los Angeles. You know how we do. My brother Stokes. He still collect to this day. He's ridiculous with the Air Max. But he used to rock these. You know
Okay.
what I mean? So I just fell in love, man, when I first seen that silhouette, yo, that joint. I was like, I gotta get those. I gotta have a pair of those. And you know, I wasn't fortunate to get every single pair. You know what I'm saying? So, it's a blessing that I can do it now. You know, I was like, yo, once the opportunity, you know, came about, I'm like, I'm gonna start collecting all the joints that I always wanted. You know what I mean? So,
Makes
and
sense.
this like I'm just showing you a small percentage of the collection. Like, I just got it. I'm in a room. I ain't even got my showroom set up, but the next time we link, I'm gonna make sure I got it
That's
right
a
for you.
bet.
And then
That's a bet.
I show you the whole layout. It's ridiculous. So,
And
but yeah, I mean, and it ain't just Air Max. You know, I obviously you see the unions, you know what I mean? You see the off-white joints, of course. You know what I
the
mean?
off-whites.
I got New Balances, Diadoras. You know, I'm just a sneakerhead, G.
And
You can't, you know, you can never fight a pair of these. You know what I mean? You can never fight a pair of these.
oh my
The
goodness, the
unions.
ones, yo,
Yeah,
the
the
union ones.
union ones, you know what I mean? So,
And shout out to you, been dropping a lot of dope collaborations with Jordan Brand, the fours, the ones.
oh
I
yeah.
mean, just crazy with it, man. And I know you mentioned, right, you say you're not just an avid fan of the Air Maxes, and I want to talk about a line. I want to talk about this sneaker too, man. You mentioned this on the Air Max King, you said Bo Jackson,
Oh,
Nike Ninja.
yeah.
Yo, talk about that sneaker. That's one of my favorite joints, man. Talk about the Bo Jackson
I
silhouette,
got a
though.
couple pair of those too.
Yes.
Yeah, yo, it's just, you know, I'm an athlete. I come from that background. So obviously, when I was coming up, I played basketball. You know, like I said, shout out to Fairfax High School. I went on to play, you know, on different levels. So basketball and athletics was a part of me coming up. So I admired athletes who had similar liking in sneaker. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
So when I first seen the Bo Jackson silhouette, I was like, yo, that
Yo,
looks crazy. Those
crazy.
trainers,
A
those
trainer.
trainers was insane, G. So,
Bo
you know,
Jackson.
absolutely. Those shoes really changed the game in that era. I remember Fight Dog rocking those in one of the tribe videos, and I was like, yo, I need those, G. I gotta get those Bo Jacksons.
The
I
Bo
mean, look at
Jacksons.
just the bounce off the athletic thing. Look at the LeBron Air Max ones. You know what I mean? These are
Just
ridiculous.
crazy, man. What one of the
It's
illest one of the
some.
illest Air Max One colorways, like
Oh
real.
yeah. Oh
Like for
yeah, you
real.
know, inspired by his infatuation with a soccer team, Liverpool.
Yep.
So he did it their colorway. It's a pretty insane silhouette. Then you got this brother named De'Aaron Fox, who plays for the Sacramento Kings.
Yep.
He dropped his Air Max ones, right? So I had to cop those too. I'm gonna always support the and these this colorway and
Whew.
this, the details in these sneakers are
Yeah, the
insane. Like
colorway is crazy. The quality, though.
he put his nickname in the sneaker. They're a little beat up. These are some of my favorite, most comfortable. So they're a little bit worn, but
Yeah.
I mean, he put his number on the tongue. You know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, these are crazy. The materials that
Crazy.
they used, like this part on the upper, is insane. It's like I don't know what material that is, bro. These are crazy. And then you got the pink Nike sign in the middle
But it
on both
all
sides.
goes together, like
Yeah, but it all goes together because you
that's what
mix
I'm
the colors up.
saying.
You know,
Like,
inspired by the basketball color right there. You know what I'm saying?
man.
So those are insane, G. A lot of athletes make, you know, dope
They really
collaborations, and
do. They really do, man.
I do support that, man. So the Bo Jacksons played a major part in that. That was the beginning of it.
That was
Like, you know,
crazy.
yeah, but even when I was a kid playing ball, I wanted the Magics, you know,
The
the Converse
Magics.
weapons.
Ooh, the Converse weapons, man. I think
Yeah.
everyone wanted those joints, dog. Like everyone, especially the Magic joints. The Magic, for real.
Man,
Go back with that guy.
I begged my pops, G. I begged my pops to get me a pair. He was like, $100 for sneakers? Like, you know, like it was
No,
a
that's how
struggle,
parents
but
love, for real.
but I got them. You know what I'm saying? So that was a big, major part, you know, in me becoming who I am
Yeah.
today as far as sneakers. You know what I'm saying? Like, that blew my mind. I was like, yo, I gotta have the Magic.
Gotta have,
So, yeah.
yo, it. And I know you mentioned like far as your background in basketball and mine too, man. I grew up playing ball throughout, grade school, high school as well. And that's one thing, man. It's like when you're on that court, you want to feel fresh, right? You want to feel fresh on the court, you know what I'm saying? Even though you don't want to, like, dang, I don't want to hoop in my fly joints because it's only
Yeah.
so many you have, but you like, damn, I got at least wear them at least once on the court, you know what I'm
Right.
saying? So that's how I
Right.
was growing up too. Like when it comes to that, like you being an athlete, especially playing ball, growing up, man, it's like, okay, you know what's fly, you know what's dope, you know what I'm saying? Just by
Course.
stepping on that court as well. So I definitely agree with you that 100% with that, man. I want to talk about just far as what I mentioned earlier, you do a great job, TriState, just you and just Gold Chain in general, like combining that fly shit with the music, man. You know what I'm saying? Like representing a lot of cats like myself as well. So growing up, man, who was some of your influences? Because I know with me, I still look at Raekwon like a superhero because what he was able to do in Ghostface as well too, Grand Puba. Did
Yeah.
that kind of dictate your, far as what you listened to growing up with cats
I
that
mean,
was fly as well?
I mean, look on the wall in the back.
Yeah.
I mean, you know what I mean? You see Kane
And
over
that's C.
there,
Kane. That's C.
Scoop and
Kane.
Scrap over there. You see Eric and Rock.
Right,
Like,
right.
you know, obviously me being from the West Coast, like those dudes was the first lyricists that I sat down and gravitated to, like, blew my mind
Yeah.
lyrically. You know what I'm saying? But I was a fan of a bunch of artists
Yes.
back then. King T, shout out to King
King
T,
T, one of the nicest. One of the
one of the
nicest.
illest
Like
lyricists
for real.
out of Compton.
Too.
And you know, just a legend, man. I've been blessed to even, you know, meet his acquaintance and be a part of his path, you know. So that was dope to actually meet him and work with him and be a part of his journey, and him be a part of mine. Also Ice Cube, NWA, you know, like, but yeah, those cats, it was a mixture of things. So like when you listen to my sound, you can hear all of that. Like you said, Grand Puba, Kool G Rap, you
Yes.
know what I'm saying? The list goes on and on. X Clan, shout out to
S Clan,
Brother Jay, who was
man, Brother Jay.
also a great friend of mine as well. But yeah, man, like a lot of that stuff shaped and molded me, those sounds and those artists, they creativity, LL, you know what I'm saying? Queen Latifah. Got to give shouts out to the Queens too. You know, those are albums that I played them to the tapes pop. You know what I'm saying?
And what was dope about all those artists you mentioned, they all had an original sound, but also they had an original style as well. Like, MC Light was fly, you know what I'm saying? Queen was fly, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so,
like, you know, all of them had their own sound, but their style to go with it as well, man. And that was really dope. And I'm starting to see that more and more as far as, like, in the hip-hop scene, right? Not too much far as, like, the mainstream, you know, perhaps, but far as just pure hip-hop, like, I'm seeing that, like, with Hus Kingpin, shout out to Hus, part of the family as well, right, part of the winners. Like, Hus always been a fly guy. Rock Marciano, fly as well. Knowledge the Pirate, then you see Griselda as well mixing that, man. Yeah. So, you see a resurgence, all family, man. So, you seeing that resurgence right now, man. You seeing that as well. You know, creeping through, man. So I love how cats like yourself and those other artists that we mentioned, man, that's keeping that sound alive, but also keeping that style too, man, keeping that originality, dog. So I want to talk about, you know, just elaborate more on originality, right? I feel like now, TriState, like, retros is a gift and a curse. I love seeing retros being re-released, right? Because a lot of things I wasn't able to get as a kid, right?
Yeah.
But I feel like I'm not seeing a lot of just dope originals, right, for some brands, like far as the original joints they drop. Do you want to see more of that, like, in the game? Because I know growing up in the 90s, I was seeing that left and right, like, just dope original styles, models dropping.
Oh, shit.
Now we really don't see that.
Shout out Soul Assassins, too. Those are my brothers, man. They also played a major role in Cat's upbringing, you know what I mean? So, shout out to the whole team over there, Muggs,
Earn Dog, Soul Assassin,
you know, the fam over there, yo. For real, they've been supporting the chain from the gate. So, shout out to them.
But yeah,
not to backtrack. I just wanted to show love to the brothers. But yeah, you're right. I feel like originality has been lost to some degree on the growth of the culture. I'm not even bad mouthing or dissing the culture. It's just a part of the journey and the way that the culture has grown. There's a lot of cloning, and cloning kind of been acceptable versus back then, the era you speak of, cloning was like shunned upon. Like, you just no way you could sound like somebody else. You know what I'm saying? There was a big issue. And if you did come across looking like you was biting, we called it biting, right?
Yes.
If it looked like even an inkling that you was copying somebody's style, you was gonna have to see them. You know what I'm saying?
Fact.
And that could mean in mad different fashions. Like, you know what I mean? Physically, you might have to battle. You know, cats, they not built for that no more.
They not.
You know, they just wanna, they, everybody, like, you know, they, it's just a different vibe. Everybody wanna be the most wavy, be the most intoxicated on something. And, you
that's
know what
real,
I mean?
Be
the
man.
Most
that's real.
And sound the most slurred, and whoever can master that style, no disrespect, that style, it's dope artists who do that, but you know the era we come from, you had to be original, G.
You had to, and I think that's affected in all type of cultures, genres, right? Like music, like you mentioned, fashion. I'm seeing niggas dressing like each other. Like, I remember I was talking to Thurston Howell the third try, so he was like, if I walked in the club and I seen someone with the same low as me, I'm going outside and taking off my shirt, because he had like five shirts under his original shirt, because just in case if he runs to someone with the same shirt as him, right? So that's how bad cats wanted to, you know, they wanted to stand out. You feel me?
Yo,
like,
oh, I'm just like that, dude. It's crazy. I'm still like that, bro. I'm still like that. My girl, she's an Air Max collector. I don't even like when she get the same joints I get, yo. Like, the shit is insane. Like, we always wanted to be different. That's why we came with, that's why we, like, Chain, me, Planet A's, we all was like, yo, everybody rocking low, we about to bring Nautica back. You know what I'm saying? Like, we wanted to go like this, G. We wanted to always be in our own lane and moving at our own pace, and you know what I mean. Stand aside, like stand alone, like stand. You know what I mean. Step up and be like, yo, y'all rocking this, we rocking this. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and that's a part of that. That's a part of the era we come from. So yeah, I feel you with that, and I feel Thurston. Shout out to Thurston.
That's
hilarious.
So and I feel like that's so true, man. And you know, and now just seeing like with hip hop, I know people have been talking about just the sales and stuff like that, and number one albums. But it goes back to like we're saying, like originality, man. I think the hip hop still is in a good space, but maybe when it comes to the mainstream or the radio, but far as just the landscape and like those artists that we mentioned that still dropping dope projects, the Griseldas of the world, Larry June of the world, Dom Kennedy, yourself, you know what I'm saying? Gold Chain Music, you know, Planet Asia, Dirty Diggs, Jamal Gasol, Vic Spencer. I mean, the list goes on. Sky Zoo, Mickey Fax doing his thing, you know. Still got the legends dropping dope shit, you know. Nas for the drop Magic too with Hit Boy. So you know, bridging the gap, you know, far as the artists of the you know, yesterday, but still doing their thing, and also artists that's right now as well. So like, it's still artists that's dropping music. I feel like people's not paying attention like they should. So, like you said, man, originality and creativity, that's something that's really like I always gravitate to, because I always want to stand out. I always want to be different from the next person to have my own style and lead. So I think, man, I'm seeing that's still going on in hip-hop. It's just going on, and when it comes to the shit that we grew up on, the shit that we follow, you know what I'm saying? So
absolutely.
I definitely want to talk about the Nautica, man, because that's what I was going to ask you next, man, because I feel like, in my opinion, TriState, like, you and Planet got some of the illest collection of Nautica, and I feel like, man, when it comes to, like, those top fashion brands, like the nostalgia joints, we hear about Low, right? Mm-hmm. People might even mention Tommy. They mention Tommy, you know what I'm saying? But, like, Nautica always stood out to me in the 90s when I was a kid, right? Because my older brother, shout out to Draymond Fly, he was in here. He used to have them Nautica windbreaker joints. And I was like, you know, like the colorways was so like different. He had like the yellow and red joint, you know what I'm saying? And like, and that's something that always gravitated me, was the color story and just how it looked, you know what I'm saying? Different. It looked different, bro. You know what I'm saying? From any other brand.
It's almost indicative of the labels, of the logos, I mean, pardon me, of the logos for each brand. Polo got the horse, and they got the, obviously, they got the bear, you know what I'm saying?
The bear.
Nautica got a sailboat.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yes. Well, what do you equivalent to the lifestyle of somebody who rocks or travels on sailboats or always on sailboats? You know what I'm saying? It's just a certain lifestyle. And to me, that gear, Nautica, they have like a urban side to that lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? That's what we gravitated to. It was like, yo, they came with, you know, similar to Ralphie shit, but you know, with a different twist to it. You know what I mean? So I definitely, you know, and back then that was 83. That was David Chu started Nautica. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I know throughout the years, once it hit the streets and we started getting a hold of it, like you see cats redesigning it and putting another flair on it. So, you know, like, and then you started seeing Nautica competition, then you started seeing Nautica challenge, and all of these different variations of the brand, but like different, you know what I mean, different channels. So, you know, you're gonna get a different vibe from each, you know, each channel that, you know, you reach out to. So, bro, we could do a whole episode on Nautica gear. Like, I probably got pieces. I got so many pieces. My Nautica collection is out of this world. You know what I'm saying?
And
I'm pretty sure, you know, and shout out to my brother Chuck Nautica. He always made sure his boy, you know, because I live in Hawaii now.
Okay.
So, I don't have the options like when I was in LA. I don't have the options. It's not a variety or big, large mixture of places that I can go to find, you know, unreleased pieces here on the island. So I really gotta dig when I want fly pieces. And you know, those rare pieces that you don't want to look like a clone.
Clone, you don't want to look
You
like no
know
clone,
what I mean?
man.
You don't want to, you know, you don't
If it
want to be out here like the Roots clones, you know what I'm saying? You know,
if it you don't want to be like that. You don't want to be
facts.
like that. That's
Yeah.
for real, man. If you had to pick one most like your most coveted piece when it comes to I want to say Nautica, man. Is it one piece of garment that's like your most coveted piece in your closet right now?
When it come to that, I think my most coveted pieces are probably like combinations, like hats and windbreaker jackets,
Windbreaker.
or just rare shit. Oh, let me show you this.
Yeah.
Hold on,
We
I'll show you this
need
one
to
because
see
this.
this. We
Hold on,
need to
I'll
see this
show you
right
this one.
here.
Something like this. So something like this. This is rare. And I got the matching hat. So this is a jacket, G, right? But this jacket is not just a regular Nautica jacket. It's reversible. So this one reversible.
Yo,
So
that joint is
it's aqua on this
crazy.
side, and if you look closely, what
Damn.
you see is the it's the Ocean Racing Series Hawaii edition. So
Damn,
one
you got
thing
the
I've
whole.
been noticing, yeah, it's crazy. Like
That's crazy.
out here, I be finding like rare pieces, even with polo. Like I've been to a few places out here, and they sell pieces that they only sell on the island, like
Island.
exclusive Hawaii pieces of Ralph Lauren. Like it's
Damn.
crazy. So you can,
Damn.
yeah. So
Didn't
that
know
was,
that.
and then I got the matching aqua hat to go with that too, which is insane. It's the Ocean Racing series as well. So those, you know, stuff like that, those are the some of the pieces, my most coveted pieces. Like it's gonna be combination pieces like that.
Yeah, man. Like the wind, they got the best windbreakers. That joint is crazy, dog. Like that
Yeah.
colorway go, it goes perfect since you in Hawaii too. That's some
You
fly
know
shit right there. Like it goes
what you
perfect
rock,
with it.
you know what I rock with that colorway, right? I always like to
Which
go
one?
here with the I always like to go here with that
Oh my
colorway.
goodness,
You know what I mean?
yo. The
Like these are
BW
the yeah, the
joints.
BW, the
The
OGBWs, like these
BWs,
and
dog.
this colorway with that combination. I never rocked it before.
Yo.
I'm just saying it's on deck. So if I'm ready to splash out on everybody, I might have to break these out
Yo.
and throw that jacket on with the hat. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, TriState, like you killed him with that. And those are my favorite Air Maxes as well, man. My homie, shout out to my homie E, man. He actually rocked them. He bought them last year, right? In New York.
Ooh.
So we stay in Tennessee. So this is before they even hit the market in Tennessee. New York had them. And he bought them at the Kip store, if I'm not mistaken, at the Kip store. So and we went to Memphis, right, in May. And we went out there, man, and he had those on with a polo collar shirt that went right with it. It was like a
Yeah.
it reminded me of some Nautica shit in a way, man, but it was fly. Like I'd never seen this polo joint in my life, dog. But he had them on with him. I was like, bro, you like you killing it. I had the Concord 11s on, but I was like, nigga, like you with those, I'm like you killing it, dog. You know what I'm saying? Like, cause no one ain't gonna have those, and they just wavy that aqua colorway, dog.
Man,
Like,
that aqua polo
light.
and that hey and awesome just personal fly shit. I'm a dark dude, so the aqua on the dark skin
Yeah.
is oh yo, you killing them.
Killing
You killing them, G.
them, dog.
You killing them.
Killing them, man. And yeah, those is prato. Like, bro, you could go in any function with them and hold your own easily.
Oh yeah.
Easily.
Oh,
Easily.
no question. No question.
Easily, man.
No question.
Easily, TriState.
Yes, sir.
Man, I want to talk about right now when it comes to the current culture, man. It's so much going on, right? Like it's a billion-dollar industry now. You got a lot of the releases is going online on sneaker apps. I remember I once upon a time go to the mom and pop shop. You could buy the sneaker, you know, be on your way out, or it might be a long line and stuff like that. But people was able to build those connections with those stores, right? It felt natural, it felt genuine. Then you got a lot of people getting into the sneaker market now, right? For reselling, they're looking at it like basically equivalent of the stock market right now, of Wall Street. That's how they're looking at it. How do you feel about just, you know, everything with the sneaker industry? It's getting real to mainstream right now. Like, how do you feel about the current culture, man? Do you feel like it's moving in the right space?
Why not? Because
Yeah.
it's just like we said in the beginning of this whole conversation. It's the same thing. It comes from us.
Yeah.
It's the culture.
Culture.
The way we rock our shoes, like come on, G, like the way we rock shit. We don't rock our gear like everybody else.
That's,
you know what I'm saying?
True,
like hip hop, people who are from this culture, we do things different. We always been different. Like when I buy sneakers, I don't normally rock these joints. You're not gonna find these in America. These, you gotta get these overseas. Now,
damn,
with something like
this
these,
crazy.
Something like these, G, they don't come with this color lace. You know what I mean?
At all.
I'm a lace swapper. I'll get a fresh new pair of joints and
yep.
swap the laces in a heartbeat just to make sure the laces vibe with how
yep.
I feel the shoe should be. You know what I'm saying?
Fact.
So when I grabbed these, I looked at the sole and was like, damn, they should have put the laces like that. You know what I'm saying?
Fact.
Instead of just regular. I think it came with like gray laces, like gray to match the suede right here around the upper. But you know, that it, and that's how we are with
yep.
everything. So you know, like why wouldn't the shoe culture turn into the hip hop industry? Like when we used to just start putting mixtapes out and selling mixtapes, it's the same
Facts.
Thing. Now cats figure, oh, everybody love these kind of sneakers. How about I cop about three pair and then resell them? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like,
facts.
Bro, it's the same flip. It's the whole from the streets hustle mentality. We came from nothing. We built the culture from nothing. So we doing the same thing with fashion. You
yeah,
know what I'm saying? We did the same
fashion.
Thing with fashion. We've been doing it. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
You know,
I agree,
I
man.
Mean,
100%.
Look at FUBU. Look at Carl Kanai. Look at Cross Colors. Like,
yep.
You know, so
started from
it's the
the
same
culture.
Thing. Yeah,
Hey,
of course, bro. Of course.
walk aware, all of them. You know what I'm saying?
Walk
You're
away,
right,
that's
man.
what I'm
Yeah,
saying.
man. And I want to talk about, man, just we mentioned this, I was talking about earlier, man, like some of the fly artists that inspire you, right? And I feel like Gold Chain Music, right? The winners, like y'all some of the flies in the game. But if you had to name some other cats, right, that's also fly, who would you name? It could be like three other artists, four other artists or groups. Who would you name that would be in the same circle, sit at the same table as you all, TriState?
Oh, that's tough, yo.
Yeah.
I like a lot of artists, bro. I listen to everything, and it ain't just hip hop too. I go everywhere. You know what I'm
yeah.
saying? So,
yeah.
But yeah, that's a tough question. That's a tough question,
yeah.
man. Right now, I'm feeling my man out of L.A. This cat named TF.
Yo, shout out to TF was on the show, man. I had on the show earlier this year, man. Shout out to the homie TF. Crazy.
Yeah,
him and 211.
Yeah, TF and 211 are they nasty, bro. I feel like TF got he on the way. He on his way.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yep, nice.
So you know, people like that. It's hard for me because I come from a big family. So a lot of my love and what I listen to is in-house, yo. It's hard
yeah,
for me to
I love that.
It's hard for me to step away from that, like you said, the winners. I'm banging a lot of that. I'm banging my family right now. You know what I mean? From K Burns to Midas the Beast. You know what I'm saying? Midas is one of my favorite right now. So
Midas is nice.
Yeah, his last project was crazy. The Devil's Playground was amazing. So that was dope.
A plus, I believe.
The kid.
A plus, yeah. A plus is nice.
He
nice
nasty.
Too. I got y'all
nasty,
A plus.
Bro.
A plus is crazy. I gotta give
he
A
nasty.
Plus. He's
Lennox,
crazy with it.
Lennox is nice. Montage one
Montage
nice.
One.
Y'all nice.
Yeah.
Like it's just you know,
is
at
nice.
The end of the day, yeah.
She
for
is.
For me, it's just.
He is crazy.
I'm like in house, bro, and it's tough. And then you know I'm on edge right now because. Planet A's about to drop that Apollo Brown.
Give me Apollo
too.
Brown, man.
That Sardines is coming, so I can't wait for the people to hear that. What they do, that's mastery. What they
that's
do,
that's mastery.
What
man.
Him and
it really
Apollo,
is.
What him and Apollo do together. So, you know, and I'm blessed because I was able to be a part of that project. So Shout out Apollo, that's my guy.
Shout
He
out to
always makes sure
Apollo,
I'm,
man.
I'm a part of what him and Age do. Of course, Age always, got me right here. So shout out to Age. Same thing, man. Like it's hard for me to get outside of that my circle,
Yeah,
But shout out to all those cats you named. You
for
know what I mean?
real.
It's a lot of dope artists out here, bro.
And I think too, man, when it comes
Rem,
to that,
I like Rem.
oh,
I like Rem.
shout out
Rem
to
is nasty. Yeah, Rem
Rem
is
is
nasty.
nasty. Shout out to
Yeah,
Rem, man.
man.
Rem, I think he just dropped a new project, if I'm not mistaken, too, man. Been dropping a lot of dope joints. Shout out to him. Shout out to my
Yeah.
man Eddie Kane. Him and
Him
Eddie
and
Kane
Eddie,
be making a
he
lot of
dope.
dope. Yeah, they
Hell yeah,
dope,
that
man.
shit is
And they
fire,
fly,
yo.
cats. Like everyone
Yeah.
we mentioned, they
They
all
be rocking
fly.
the trenches.
Yo,
They be
they rock
rocking the
the
trenches and shit.
trenches and all
Yeah,
that,
that's
dog.
hard.
Like they all fly,
Yeah.
man. All
And
fly artists.
the visuals be
Visuals
dope. Yeah.
be
Like the
dope,
visuals
man.
be killer.
It be
Yeah,
killing,
that's how you,
man.
that shit is hard, G.
It be killing, man. Like you mentioned, the visuals be dope, man. And those artists is dope on the mic, but also they have a certain style to them to go along with
Yeah.
it too. You know what I'm
Yeah.
saying? Like they be
Yeah.
fly as hell, man. So that's
No
why I
doubt.
like. That's why I love that, man. So, all right, TriState. I always ask all the artists this question, right? If you had to pick a sneaker that's equivalent of your music style, what would it be, dog? I know that's tough. That's tough right there.
You asking the Air Max King?
I know, man. If it's a particular Air Max, I'm gonna say a particular Air Max, man.
Mean just one shoe?
One shoe. Like, if you had to pick one sneaker, right, that's the equivalent of your music style, what would it be, dog? If it's one Air Max.
I'm trying to see, did I bring them out here? Yeah, I mean, it could be something like this. Could be like the Witherspoon. I don't, you know what it is?
Sean Witherspoon.
Yeah, those are always,
My
I
God.
beat those up. I don't know. That's too hard,
That's
bro.
hard.
You like
It's a lot. It's a
asking me to
lot.
pick my
Yeah,
favorite. You like asking me to pick my favorite song off the project. That's crazy.
That's
Yeah,
great.
I
I know
don't
it's
know.
so many, man.
It's
It's so many,
too
man.
many. It's too many.
And behind you,
What
right? Because you
about
got.
these? What about these? What about
Yo.
these? You know
Yo.
about these? Yeah, I know you know about these.
Yo, those
These are
crazy,
the
though.
Air Max day that have a night day joint.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
Those
saying?
joints is crazy. Like, and
Yeah, the
it's
detail is
exclusive.
ridiculous. Yeah, the details are
Yo.
ridiculous, like on those. You know what I mean? With the
Never
bubble
seen
gum.
those in person,
Yeah,
just on the net,
these are
just pics.
insane, bro.
But looking at
Yeah.
them right, crazy. And yo,
Crazy.
and
It's
speaking of
too
the,
many, bro.
it's
It's
too
too
many.
many.
So speaking of the collection that you have right now, TriState, what's some of the ones that you got? I know you got a lot right now in front of you and also behind you, dog. What's some of the other joints you want to show off right now, man, to everyone, dog? Like any
Shoes,
other joints,
like
yeah, any joints you want to show off? Because I see you pulling out
anything.
heat. Like
Well,
nonstop. What do you?
I right today I got on the Escapes, actually. I got these on.
All
Let me
right.
take these off. These are comfortable as hell, my bro.
Yo, you got the escapes on?
Yeah, these are hella comfortable. And of course I swapped the laces out, you know what I'm saying? So these joints is pretty crazy, of course. I mean, I like exclusive joints that nobody really rocks. I know I've been showing you a lot of heat, but the vinyls is probably some of my favorite, of course. These joints is crazy, the patent
Yeah, they're
leather.
crazy. They're crazy.
I
They're
call these
crazy.
I call these the passion fruits. You know what I mean?
Man, but those is crazy, man.
Yeah,
Those
those
is
is nuts.
crack. Those is grail. Those
Yeah,
grails right there. Now those
these are
grails.
grails. These are definitely grails. I mean, it I could go on all night, G. It's just a bunch of shoes that I really love. Of course I got all the lemonade ones. I got the limeades, the lemonade,
Yeah.
strawberry, all of that. You know what I mean? So like stuff like that. I mean, I don't know. It's hard to, when you say your favorite, it's just
Yeah,
hard to pick one.
it's tough, man.
It's
It's
hard to
tough. You're
pick
right. It's
one.
so many. It's so many joints that
Yeah.
you have that sentimental value to go along with it too. I'm gonna say one of my favorite Air Maxes, is the Huffquake Air Max 90s.
Ooh,
The Huffquake, so I
those is
say it was
crazy. Yeah, those is
crazy,
crazy. I don't
crazy,
have those.
man.
Yeah, I don't have
Those
those.
is
Yeah, those are crazy. Yeah,
crazy,
those are.
dog. Like, I want them
You know
so
what's
bad.
insane? It's crazy because we could go on back and forth all day naming off shoes.
Yeah.
And I guarantee, and all shoe collectors probably feel the same way. There's a pair that got away from
yes.
me. You know
yes.
what I mean?
No, for like, real. That's a pair that got away.
I mean, I copped these too recently. These are some of the recent cops with the denim.
That was crazy.
Denim
yeah,
with
those.
The animal. Yeah. With the
those
rope lace like that.
Those crazy. Yeah, those crazy.
Detail is insane. And then look how the upper look,
the
you know what I'm saying?
Quality.
On the toe box.
But Nike,
yeah, the toe
keep
box.
Doing,
is
but
crazy.
No, Nike been doing their thing with the Air Max ones. Like the Pata Air Max ones was crazy. Like, the Patas, they did crazy. They was doing numbers, like, for real.
Yep.
They was doing their thing with that collaboration, dog.
I still been trying to get my hands on some of those, too.
Yes.
Anybody out there want to reach out to the God, send me something. Yeah, you know what I mean?
Real
reach
fact.
Out to me. Hit me
real
on
talk.
IG, send me
real
something.
Talk.
You got a collection. You got some joints. 12 and a half, 12, whatever. 12, 12 and a half, 13. I'll squeeze it to some 12. You know what I mean? Reach out to me. Let me know what's good. I'm here. I want to see what you got.
So, I know you mentioned too, like, because it's some in my you know collection or some sneakers that got away from me. TriState. Is it that one sneaker like that got away from you, or that one sneaker that you've been wanting since you was younger, but you haven't got yet?
Yeah, it's a pair of 90s that I want real bad. They call it a Species.
Species.
Air Max 90 Species. Yeah, they like you seen the movie Species?
Yeah, I've seen it. I've seen the movie okay. Species.
Yeah, they patent after that. They like all gray on the upper, like a crushed
yeah.
suede, and they got scales on them, like a
damn, like the actual Species, like the actual
yo. And the sole is like the sole is lime green, but it's like ice green. You can like see it's clear.
Damn.
Oh, they insane, bro. I've been trying to get my hands on a pair of these for a minute.
And that's the joints that got away. That got
those,
away,
yeah,
man. Get
yeah,
those
because,
right there, though.
Because I had an opportunity to grab them, and I didn't grab them.
Grab them.
And
yeah.
And now they, you know, now you know how the resale market is. Now they
yeah.
just insane.
Insane,
so,
man.
That was one pair that got away. You know, it's probably hundreds of pairs that got away, but yeah, that one hurts.
That's you know, and I got a couple of joints like that got away from me, so I could definitely understand.
Give
that,
me
though,
one,
for real.
Give me one.
So I will say, man, if I had to get one, it's the Columbia 11s, the OG Columbia 11s. That's a pair that I want so much. I want the Columbia 11s. I want those. The Doom Dunks.
Ooh.
I want the Doom SBs.
Yeah, the Doom Dunks is crazy.
The Doom SBs. I want the first collaboration between De La Soul and Nike, the Nike De La Soul Dunks. I want those.
Fire.
Like that.
Fire.
Those are joints I really want because I was in, I want to say I was in high school, 12th senior year when they first dropped, and I wanted those so bad. I was doing the time you had to go into skate shops and get the SBs or get the, you know, the Dunks and stuff like that. So. I would say those, man, those joints is the ones I really like want, man. You know what
yeah.
I'm saying? So,
yeah.
So those are joints. And I was working at the time when the SB Dunes dropped, when the Dunes dropped and I couldn't get them like, damn. So, but yeah, I want those bad. It's another mm-hmm. joints, man. I would say this too, man, the Deodor, the purple tape joints, the Deodor joints
Ooh.
From Raekwon.
Yeah,
that's another
fire.
Joints.
Yeah,
those was crazy.
Fire.
Those joints,
yeah,
I want to get those too.
Absolutely.
I want to get those too, man. So
Absolutely.
It's a couple, man, in my collection that got away from me, TriState, man.
You,
for real,
you know,
so.
Speaking of that, I just thought about a pair too. The 95, Air Max 95 animal,
yes.
The animal print.
The 95. The 95.
Yeah. Yeah, the animal pack.
Yes.
It's the first 95 animal pack.
That's a crazy one. That's a crazy one. I'm gonna go ahead and say this too. This is another one of my favorites. The Air Max one, the Safari joints.
Yeah, Safari, yeah.
The safari joints,
Oh,
right? Since
you about to make me go in
yeah,
the room
the
and bring the
safari
safaris out.
joints,
I'm about to go grab the safari.
the safari
Yeah, the
joints though,
safaris is
TriState.
dope. Yeah, the
The safari
safaris dope.
is crazy, man.
Yeah,
And something that I wanted to mention, man, was on your Instagram page, how you putting the fits together, dog? Fars with the Air Maxes, man. Talk about what made you want to start doing that, man, because I love those visuals, dog.
You know what it is? I don't even think it's premeditated, G.
Yeah.
It's just energy. Like, you know, it's just how I'm feeling. Like I knew I was gearing up to get ready to get a world of Air Max EP,
Yeah.
but I didn't know if everybody really knew why I would put out a project called Air Max King. Like, if you don't really know me like that, you probably don't know that my Air Max collection is how it is. You know what I'm saying? So,
Yeah.
it started out just straight up just feeling like this how I was feeling. Wake up in the morning, you know, yo, I'm gonna rock this today. Let me take a picture of this. Let me
Yeah.
post it. You know what I'm saying? So it was just natural energy in the beginning, and then it started making sense because I was like, yo, Air Max month, my brother Stokes, he constantly dropping pictures every
Yeah.
day, like this Air Max, this. I was
Yeah.
like, yo, let me jump in the mixture and show cats what I really got and how I really live. Like, I'm not gonna just throw the music out there and not really be living like
That's a
that.
good
So
point.
I really took on that, you know, that title Air Max King. I was like, yo, I might as well show the world that, yo, and I got pairs. I could go months probably, you know what I mean,
Yeah,
every day.
man.
You know what I'm
Yeah,
saying?
no. You could definitely go months. You could like go years with that shit, because the joints that you, not only that you put in the sneaker, but you putting like the fit with it too. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn,
I mean,
like, yo,
that's what we
that's
do.
what,
We match it.
you
We
know what I'm
matching
saying?
up the gear and the outfits. It's just natural. You know what I'm saying? We
Natural,
do it
man.
every day. It's an everyday thing, and we do it unconsciously. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'll pop up at the studio and niggas, oh shit, yo,
Yeah.
oh damn, that looks hard. You're like, yo, where you get that from? You know, and the whole crew, like I said, the whole crew is like age like that
Yeah,
too. You know what I
it's
mean?
like that too.
Dirty
For
Digs.
real.
I don't
Dirty
know if you're
Digs.
familiar with Dirt Digs,
No,
but
I had them on the show last
oh,
year. Last year, Dirty
dope,
Digs, yo,
dope. Those is
they crazy.
those are that's my family, G. So
That's
it's
crazy.
the it, you know, it's the same way. We all trying to pop up and outshine. Like, yo,
Yeah.
you're not right. You ain't never seen these before.
Yo,
You ain't never seen
yo,
this. You ain't
facts.
never seen this fit before. You
For
know what I'm saying? Like,
real.
that's how we do, G. You know what I mean? And my boy, I go back and forth with my good brother, Chuck Nautica, on the Nautica pieces. Like, I'd be like, I know you don't got this,
Yeah.
Steve. 'Cause
Yeah.
I got this overseas, so I know you're
Yeah.
not. I know you didn't cop this, you know. But yeah, it's just a part of
That's
the whole
love,
fabric, the
man.
whole
Yeah.
lifestyle, bro. So, you know, we're gonna continue to push, you know, push, you know, push the meter forward in terms of fashion, sound, culture, everything, yo. So, you know, it's just what we do.
And I want to ask this question before we go to TriState. When it comes to like touring and going and performing live, right? Is the particular shoe that you rock, you know what I'm saying, when you perform, do you bring your grills? Do you bring all your heat, or you bring some joints that just comfortable that you don't want to mess up? Like, how do you go into that mindset? Because I know with me, I probably want to perform all my heat, then I realize like, damn, I done jumped around. You know what I'm saying? Done did all type of
Nah, it
crazy
don't
stuff,
matter.
right?
It
Like,
don't it don't
don't.
matter. We got them to rock them. So yeah,
Got you.
I bring whatever out the closet. You know, I've worn off-whites. You
Okay.
know, to do shows, I've worn New Balance. I've worn you know, it's just
Whatever.
whatever I'm feeling that day, and whoever we rocking with. If we on the road and it, you know, we know what we dealing with, what kind of monster we dealing with. So you sometimes you gotta bring the big guns.
Yeah, right. You're right.
You
You're
know what
right.
I'm
You're
saying?
right.
So
You're right.
yeah,
You're right,
so
dog. Like
it just
Dion
depends.
Sanders
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Like
Exactly.
Dion said, what you dress good, you feel good, you're gonna perform good. You know what I'm
There you
saying?
go.
That makes sense.
Exactly.
That makes sense,
Exactly.
dog, with that
Exactly.
100%, man. And I know that you
Absolutely.
mentioned New Balances, man. New Balance has been dropping some crazy joints too, Trust. I love the 550s. I was talking to one of my homies about it.
Yeah,
Like, the
550s.
550s been crazy, dog.
550s,
Man.
we I mean we you know every I mean if you don't have it, to me, to be a part of this culture, you gotta have a pair of 550s.
The 550s
Like, you know what I
is
mean? Like,
crazy.
550s is a must have.
Must.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
Man.
so and
Beautiful
then you know what
sneaker.
you know what's killer about those? But they uncomfortable as hell though. I ain't gonna front. But you know what I mean? They look dope. I wouldn't want to rock them to a festival. You know, I wouldn't wear them to like we going to do a festival. I'm not rocking those. You know
Hey, Troy, I just turned my sister-in-law into the 550s this weekend, man. So, and I
what
was,
I'm saying? I hope she's
and she,
not on her feet all day, G. She gonna be mad at you.
hey, man, I need to hit her up because she went to the Beyonce show, dog, and she had the 550s on, G. And so
But you know, but you know, everybody's feet different though.
They
We
are,
you know, you
though.
know. Shapes and you know, flat feet, heels, you know, arches, all kind of differences in feet. So what might be uncomfortable to me might be comfortable to her. You know what I'm
That's
saying?
true.
So
That's true. That's a good point. That's a good point,
yeah,
man.
so
Not a,
cause to
the
me, Jordans suck in comfortability, in my opinion. That's just me.
Yo,
So
the tens is terrible on my damn pinky toe. I don't know what it is, TriState. The tens is uncomfortable.
Yeah.
The fours, I ain't gonna lie, I love the fours, but the fours is
Yeah.
uncomfortable at
I know.
times. Like, for real,
I know.
the phones
Ones ones are
what?
some of the most even Jordan said it himself, G. If you watch the documentary, if you
He
watch
was his toe was bleeding. It was
last
the one with the ones.
exactly, bruh.
It was
So
bleeding.
even he know, like, yeah, they wasn't definitely was not for comfort. Like, you know,
Real.
The threes, fours, fives, those are some of my favorites, but they not really comfortable, bruh.
And
You know what I mean? That's why I started moving those out of the collection and moving Air Max in, because I could wear them all day.
can
My
wear
feet
them
feel
all
good. I'm
day.
not blistering
Yep.
up. I'm not,
Yep.
you know, so yeah, bro.
Yeah, you can
So
wear them all day, man. I know my brother mentioned
absolutely.
one of the Air Max ones that he still want was the Atmos. Is it the Atmos? The elephant joints?
The
Air
app,
Max one. Yeah, the Atmos. Yeah, the
ooh,
elephant
Atmos
joints.
is
He mentioned
dope. Yeah,
those
those are dope.
in the comment. Those
Ooh,
is
those are
crazy. Those is
crazy.
crazy. Yeah, I
Yeah.
definitely had to say that
Yeah, I
for real,
gotta
because
get a
I was like,
pair of those. I still gotta get a
that's
pair of those
gross.
too.
Those crazy.
With the
Yeah,
elephant
the
print.
elephant
Yeah, those
print on it.
the
Yeah,
elephant.
those
Yeah,
is
those are the elephants.
crazy.
They call them
Those
the
is
elephants.
crazy. The
Yeah,
crazy. I remember another dope Air Max. I think it was the hemp joints. It was made like with actual hemp. And it was the 90s, I believe. I think it was the Air Max 90s or the Air Max ones.
I got some 90s
Yeah,
that's hemp.
the nice hemps.
I got some hemp 90s.
And the bottom was
That's what
like hemp, if I'm not mistaken.
but you do know that that's what all the crepe, the whole crepe edition is. That's what
Yes.
it is. Like these. Like this
Yes.
is crepe. Like that's that bottom is that hemp. That's
Hemp.
that, you know what I mean? But
Dang,
yeah, that
hemp.
material is
It's
crazy.
crazy,
That
though.
material is real
It's
crazy.
crazy, man. It's crazy
Absolutely,
for
yeah.
real.
Yeah,
Man.
these are dope.
I love those. Because you could wear those with so many different fits. You could be
Oh,
casual.
man.
You know, you could wear them like with a damn suit if you wanted to. Like
You know what I'm saying?
Air Max Ones,
What's
man.
the
It's
illest shoe to rock with a suit ever in the history of our culture?
I'm gonna say a couple. Jordan ones. I think Jordan
Okay.
ones just is
Okay.
Jordan threes. The black and cinnamon threes or the white ones is two of the illest joints you could wear with a suit. I would say the Air Max ones isn't on that list, and the Air Force ones.
Yeah.
Those are the ones, you know. Then I got honorable mentions. I got Stan Smiths.
Okay, okay,
I got shell
okay,
toes. If you want to keep
okay,
it just safe,
okay.
you know, those some honorable mentions as well. But you know, if I could throw wallabies, you know, I could throw it. It's like, you know, if you want
Yeah.
to put that in the sneaker mode, you can
Ooh,
throw
I definitely
wallabies
would
as
say
well.
Wally.
Wally's is
Definitely would say
definitely
Wally.
Wally's is in there for sure,
Yeah.
man. But it's a lot, man. Shout out to my man DR who just joined. Shout out to DR. Shout out to everyone else
Yes,
that
indeed. Shout out to
that's in
everybody.
here. You feel me? But TriState, man, just want to say thank you once again, dog, for coming on the show, man. Truly appreciate you, man. Thanks for everything you've been doing, dog. Shout out to my big bro, Draven Fly, again, because he put me up on your music years ago. It was a project you did with Oh No, right? And
Yeah,
he the
so that's three
three-dimension.
dimension, yeah, three dimensional prescriptions.
Yeah.
One of my favorite projects,
Man.
solo projects ever. Shout out to
Yeah.
Hyro. Shout out to Hyro, all the Hyro family. You know that album came out on
Yes.
the Hieroglyphics label.
Yeah.
So
Yeah,
shout out
man.
to all my brothers that's a part of that legendary crew,
Yeah.
the Hyro
Yeah.
crew. And yeah, that was a big
That
project
was a
for me,
dope
man.
project,
Thank
man.
you.
That was a dope project. My
Thank you.
brother, my brother sent it to me, man, and I was like, damn, this nigga is dope, like dope, man. He was like, yeah, man, from Cali, you know what I'm saying? He rolled with Planet Asia and stuff like that. I was like, for real? And
Thank
been
you.
locked in ever since then, man. Been
Yeah.
locked in, bro, for real, man. So I
Well,
love
this
the
right
project.
here, you mentioned that project. This project right here is probably my favorite project I was a part of right here. See that?
That's just, yeah, I see. So what make it stand? That's Durag Dynasty, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yes,
Was that
sir. That's
Durag
exactly what
Dynasty?
it is. That's
Okay.
exactly what it is. This
Durag
is the
Dynasty.
limited. This is the limited edition deluxe pack. It comes with a custom durag. Comes with the CD,
And I was
stickers, everything.
and
You
I
are not gonna find one of these packs.
that Durag Dynasty album was so dope. I'm gonna say this too, TriState. I feel like that album was ahead of its time because that was the first time I really heard Alchemist do a full-length project outside of Mobb Deep, outside of Prodigy and Half, if I'm not mistaken. I think he did one with Currency before. I think he
Well,
did one with Currency, but
and he did one with Damo Genesis
Dom,
too.
oh yeah, No Idols, the No Idols
Yeah,
joint,
no
right?
idols.
The
Yeah,
No
yeah.
Idols,
Now
but
he was doing full length joints,
joint,
but I think the reason why you feel like that, cause ours was more groundbreaking, like sound wise. No disrespect, I love the No Idols joint. Currency's joint was dope too, but our project, it was special, y'all.
it
It
was.
just it was from the selection of production, the way we put the album together.
Yeah, it was
Yeah,
dope. It was dope.
it
It
was
was dope. The
that
visuals was
project.
dope too, man. The one with Prodigy y'all had. Y'all had a
Yeah,
visual for the
and
joint you did
Fish
with
P. Yeah,
Prodigy, man.
rest in
Rest in
peace,
peace to
rest in
Pizza
peace,
P,
P.
man.
Yo, P was a super authentic individual. You know what I mean? Like he
Yeah.
definitely hold no bars, like spoke his mind. He was conscious. I got a lot of love and respect for what P did for the
Yes.
culture. You know what I mean? And it's along the same lines of what we do in terms of making sure that there's substance involved when we create. So shout out to that whole Mob family. That's another
Yes, shout to my
extension too.
family.
Big Twins, that's my
Big
brothers. I
twin.
got a my upcoming project. I'm about to drop a joint on y'all real soon, called Audio Flambe, and
Woo. Just the
produced by the
title
great.
sound crazy.
Yes, it actually the project was produced entirely by a 5-star chef, a real
Damn.
life a real life chef. He's a great brother of mine. His name is we call him the Crate Chef. So shout out to the Crate Chef. He did the whole project. Yeah, I got a joint on there with Big Twins. That's one of my favorite joints right
Shout
now,
out to
bro.
Twins, man.
I
Shout out to
can't stop
Twins.
playing that joint. Yeah, shout out to
Shout out to Twin, man. Shout out to the whole
my
infamous man.
brother, my
For
man, my
real,
brother.
Twin, man.
Yeah.
And that's something too, man. Kind of, getting a little bit off topic, but I feel like P and Prodigy embrace like, LA rap scene. I feel like, before his death, man, like Domo Genesis,
Yeah.
yourself, Planet Asia,
Yeah.
Alchemist, we already know, but so many other artists like Blue, like he was embracing that whole scene, man. And that's one thing I really loved about P, and like he embraced other artists. And you don't really see that a lot of artists from his stature, you know what I'm saying?
But
Like, then,
he only embraced cats he fucked with,
yeah,
because
true,
like
true,
he would let it be known if he wasn't fucking with certain things. And
yeah.
that's the part, that's what I'm talking about with as far as generosity and being genuine, a genuine dude, because
Yeah.
if he wasn't feeling it, he wouldn't have jumped. He wouldn't have been on fish meat if he wasn't fucking with it.
True. That's true. That's a good point, man.
Fucking with Asia, myself, and Al.
Yeah.
So, you know, of course, him and Al was like blood brothers in there. You know what I mean? So, you know, that was one of the advantages. But, yeah, for sure. That project was I mean, bro, Nori was on that project. A lot of people don't even know that, probably. Like, Noriega did the introduction on on the song with Imam Thug. You know what I'm saying?
Damn. Yeah, so. Damn, I forgot about that. Damn, Nori. Yeah, so,
Mm-hmm. You know, Evidence was on there.
Yes.
You know, like, but,
Evie,
but it wasn't,
Evie.
You know, Chase Infinite, of course. You know, so.
Shout out to the homie Chase Infinite. Yeah. Legend.
Yeah, one of the illest lyricists out of
Chase, LA, good dude.
Ever. Yeah, of course. So,
good dude.
But yeah,
man.
I mean, you know, we definitely, that album will stand the test of time. If anybody knows this culture and know hip hop, you can never take that album away from it. Gold Chain, Planet Asia, Killer Ben, and TriState put that album in the Hall of Fame, in the Rap Hall.
Yeah,
of Fame.
Man. I love the concept, love the title, love the you know, the album cover, man, with the Lakers, with Pat Riley, with the do-rag. Like, everything was dope about just that concept, man, and just everything about it. And the beats was grimy. The beats was just, know what I'm saying?
Every
like,
single song, none of that shit. It wasn't, we didn't make that album. Alchemist didn't say, here's some beats and go record shit.
Yeah.
That was us every single day jumping in somebody's whip and driving to the Alchemist house and him cooking right on the spot and us cooking right there and boom, song, put that in the chamber and boom, boom, boom. That album was magic.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It was, so, man. I love it, man. I love that Durad Dynasty, man. I love you. I know you mentioned you got a new project dropping, right? Is there anything else that you're working on, TriState, that you want to let the people know?
It's a lot of things in the chamber.
Okay.
You know, but you know, I got my hands in a lot of stuff, bro. I'm a businessman too, so you know, a lot of time go into that. You know,
I know you mentioned
food on the table.
I know you mentioned, you know, property, land, real estate. You mentioned on the album, man.
Okay,
you know,
I see you be listening.
I listen, dog. Like, yo, you got real estate. I'm like, okay, I see that.
You
right,
listening.
Man.
Okay, you listening. Okay, yeah. And that's the thing. You know, I'm a part of a group of individuals. Like, my company is called De Facto, and I have partners. And what we do is, we bridge relationships with businessmen, you know, and that could be in several different fashions. But yeah, we've taken part in large real estate investments. We also own. So I'm part owner of two professional soccer franchises.
Damn.
One of those teams play out of Phoenix called the Phoenix Rising. And then
it's rising. I know about them.
Yeah, and then the other club is a new expansion team that will be joining the USL this year, called Rhode Island Football Club. So
that's major. That's next level, TriState. That's level shit. For
we
real.
Don't talk about shit like that. You know, we like, you know, you listen to the raps. At the end of the day, I just encourage everybody to listen to the music. We not talking about no bullshit. If you hear something and you caught it, more than likely it's factual.
Yep.
You know what I mean? And you on the right page. So you heard it. It's definitely what it is.
Yeah, man. I love that, bro. Cause that's inspiring, man, for real. Cause even when you mentioned that, I was like, damn, that's dope as hell. You know what I'm saying? That's those type of vibrations that we need, man. We need to hear, man. So I love what you're doing with that, man.
Thank you.
You're doing outside of the booth as well, man.
Thank
keep doing you, TriState, sir. Man. And you know you're welcome back anytime, dog. Anytime on the show.
Yeah, we
got
to do the Nautica.
Back,
we got to do the Nautica edition.
I'm down. We got to do the Nautica edition for real. I love that, man. Right. Nautica edition next, dog. I'm down with that,
sir.
For real, man.
Okay.
I love that, dog. Keep doing your thing, man, out there, man. And keep doing you. And thanks to everyone for rocking with Yo, It's the Kicks. It's your man, AB, with the legend TriState. And we signing off, man. So peace.
Chain.
What's good, everyone? Welcome to another edition of Yo, It's the Kicks. Got another classic episode today. What a legendary artist, a dope artist from California, representing from Gold Chain Music, my man TriState. So excited to have him on the show today. Let me bring him on live right now. He just popped in, so. What's good, everyone? I see a lot of people joining right now for today's episode. So thanks, everyone, for joining. My name is AB. Welcome to another edition of Yo, It's the Kicks. Got my man TriState, and he'll be on shortly, representing Gold Chain Music. So it's going to be another dope episode. Thanks to everyone that tuned into our last episode this past Monday with Skyzoo, where we talked about his album, The Mind of a Saint, and also Sneakers, right? Yo, It's the Kick. So it's only right. So it was another legendary episode. So cranking out two episodes this week. So excited about that. Excited, you know, for our next guest coming up on the show. But for anybody that's new to Yo, It's the Kicks and GrailzInc, make sure to follow us at GrailzInc to check out our past episodes as well, because we got over about 200 episodes with a lot of legendary artists. So definitely check those episodes out. So we got episodes with Willie Esco, the legendary fashion designer. We got episodes with Vic Spencer, episodes with Durson Howe III, Torrey. So many dope artists, you know, so many dope artists that we follow and we enjoy and love. So check them out. And also, you know, fashion designers too, and people who just fans of the sneaker culture. But definitely check those episodes out. So let me go ahead and bring my man TriState on.